She went to visit nuns and gave birth to her vexation to identical twin sons.
If anyone would dare to compete with all your lies, they'll fall into a snare and quickly realize they simply can't afford to. Your tongue is so much shorter, they really should award you the order of the Girder.
I am sure. Next to you, I'm just an amateur. In every drawing room, I frequently do hear tell that no one can assume they are safe from Lady Sneerwell.
The two boys can compile things on me to condemn until they see the vile things that I have on them.
Of lies there'll be a flood worse than that afflicting Noah.
You'll drag them through the mud, my dear constricting boros snake.
You're my patron saint. I kneel at your every shrine.
Your tongue got me fit like serpentine, turpentine. So with a secret spot, my bosom let me clasp you. I'm the queen of the Nile, and you are my Ascuse.
When there's a tale to tattle, my tale will rattle.
Your soul will deptile, praise you, my reptile.
And there's no one unkinder than your precious sidewinder.
My charmed and abiding,
your poisonous crawling. But my lady, entre nous, there is but one affair that I haven't any clue as to why you'd even care to devote such great attention to the family of Sir Peter Teazle. And it's beyond my comprehension why you dote on such a weasel as Joseph Surface, while the other you attack, poor Charles, his brother. And you're trying to destroy Charles's love with Jesus' word, Mariah. Even though the handsome boy's already a pariah for his drunken rowdy ways and extravagance in bars. He wastes all of his days and his reputation scars. Without your help or your assistance. So, from my not too great distance, I don't mean to seem to dance, but it doesn't make much sense.
Our seducive surface, I'll unravel the mystery. Love has no share whatever in our recent history. He's far, far too clever. Mariah gets her inheritance soon, and that's why he wants her, and his brother here impugn, thinking that once her doubts about Charles are raised, then he can sweep her off her feet. She'll be so amazed, she'll marry him, but sweet.
But please, my lady, share. Why should you even care?
You cannot guess it? Oh, must I confess it?
My lust is so obscene for that handsome libertine who's extravagant and drunk and who's of dealers in lies, and this it, our unholy trinity now is complete. Enough of all this, and now, without quibbling, a thing still amiss with poor Charles, your sibling. Have his misfortunes hemmed my way? She mustn't become his fiancée, and to be rather blunt, does she know what you want?
Nevertheless, I conceal my actual true motivations. What Moriah would say would cause such dismay, and rather undo complications. That pretense is better than truth, and so in defense of the youth, I swear up and down all over the town that I pity my poor brother's troubles. But I smile like the Sphinx while pouring him drinks, and making quite sure that they're doubles.
But I and I will Charles be mine.
If anyone could see, he forever forgets young women and beauty and wit and coquette, and would pay off his creditors and gambling debts, and all his back taxes now due. If anyone could make him a wonderful wife, and make him desire a celibate life, it would be you.
Retract my claws. I wouldn't want to scratch the surface. But let's postpone our conniving. Mariah's arriving. Joseph, therefore, please look devout. Snake, use the back door and let yourself out.
Mariah!
Candour. Hello, hello, have you heard? It's so bad.
to learn to fake it. It's the lesser of the sins. She simply have to take it. Right on board. Up her chin. Really, Mr. Candour, now my life of the floor is your affair of with Charles because of his extravagance. See here, the entire time dwells on nothing else. So what would you have against me here?
Oh, what a slur! Where is your tact?
Please help me out. This talk is misanthropic. On her, I'm straight down by here.
land, now rises from a moor. Though she flatters herself to be indeed a modern devotee, she finds it rather hard to breed her Nova Scotia sheep. I must ride and tell her of my friend, Lady Diana Burton, to see what she has to recommend. For she has a little that to her better that she's a conservative.
My lady, some privileged information you must promise not to tell from Mariah's poor relation, who's a shepherdess as well. She had sparkling news of Lady Diana, devoured by shepherds who came in from Canada. She's so desperate for a kid, she'll do anyone, God forbid.
Mrs. Candour, I have something to divulge about her lady's new whisper. Oh, the news is vital draw, so you mustn't tell us so. The reason Lady Bly is no longer thin is because of an affair she had with a shepherd from within. He's such an ugly cur that's given his awful look in order to remain with her. He must have an enormous crook.
Gentlemen, should get around. It really would not do, but since this news was quite as done, I will whisper it to you. All my sources of this night, I think I've got it right. Oh, this was such immoral times. We must protect DeYoung. In spite of his awful, terrible crimes, Lady Bly married a crook who was hung, and then she took solace with General Cornwallis. And as near as I can tell, with a German shepherd, as well.
Oh, Mariah!
You never guess what we have heard.
You mustn't breathe a single word.
They've sentenced Lady Bly,
who was a German spy.
General Schaffer, she's
off to the colonies.
And then there was some trade.
She shared with Catherine the Great.
Maybe we got the Russian
confused with the Prussian. I cannot quite recall if I have caught it all, but when my memory fails, I just invent all the details.
This is nonsense, of course. Whomever was your source?
It's exactly as you told me, so why are you so upset? You really should have told me you began it. Don't forget!
I can't imagine why the poor girl now withdraws.
Perhaps I ought to fly and bear it at the cause.
She cannot resist you. Come, I'll assist you.
Oh, you must know the news. I am not the one who is first with this, I would guess. Because of the booze your brother's undone, I'm sure it must cause you distress.
You know I was told that everything sold, that he could easily move. Mr. Surface, you cannot approve.
All that's left are the dregs of a few rotten cakes and the family quarters in the halls. But as near as I can tell, he would sell them all as well if they were painted right on the walls.
I did hear another bad story or other,
though it wasn't an actual crime.
But as he's your brother,
we'll tell you in private
some other appropriate time. But I'm a liar, shows too much concern for him.
Don't worry, dear, never you fear. I know we will win, united in sin. So let us begin.
I've spent 6 months of my life enduring nothing but her disrespect. I know it seems odd, but I tell you it's true. I'd bet you any amount on it at our wedding, swear to God, instead of I do, she loudly proclaimed, don't count on it. There isn't any curse as bad as better or for worse, for in this awful matter, I always get the letter. What's annoying is the way she was never in our bed the whole night for the honeymoon from her. Now she lies in it all day, wishing I were dead or locked up in a badly padded cell. She spends all I make, she tends to partake of gossip while playing at cards. She makes free with her lies about me, sans disguise, while my character lies there in shards. Though a country girl before, now she's become a city bore, who claims she's never seen a tree outside a park. And what's really more perverse, I find her bite is even worse than the incessant noisy chatter of her bark. I know in my heart, till death do us part, means you may need a gun or a knife. When an old bachelor marries a young wife.
Sir Peter, your servant. How are you, sir?
A good question to ask a married man.
Nay, your wife can't be the cause of your unhappiness.
Why? Has anybody told you she is dead? And now Moriah, my ward, refuses Joseph Surface, whom I have chosen as her husband. She wants to marry his spendthrift brother instead.
Charles, I'll bet you'll reform. Their father, once my revered master, was also wild in his youth. But by the time he died, he was a pillar of the community.
You are wrong, Master Rowley. After their father died, you know, I acted as guardian to both of them, till their uncle Sir Oliver's generosity made them independent. Joseph is a model young man, but Charles has dissipated his inheritance. My old friend Sir Oliver would be mortified.
We'll know soon. Sir Oliver has arrived.
What? I thought you did not expect him this month.
His passage has been remarkably quick.
Does he still order us not to inform his nephews of his arrival?
Yes, he plans to test their characters.
He won't need a trick to reveal their worth. But does he know I am married?
Yes. And he can't wait to congratulate you.
No, Oliver will laugh at me. We both vowed never to marry, but he has been the only one to keep his promise. But don't say a word that Lady Teazle and I ever disagreed. I'd prefer he think that we're a happy couple.
Indeed.
Lady Teazle, Lady Teazle, I'll not stand for it.
Sir Peter, Sir Peter, in all candor, it doesn't matter to me in the least. Now, dearest, don't be a beast.
want. Well, my dear, to other topics. These flowers here
are from the tropics.
Yes, my darling, but remember, today's the last day of November. My lady, I simply can't endure another unneeded expenditure. It's time you were most dear, they're too expensive this time of year.
If it's not
I've done for you, I've abandoned everyone for you. I made you a woman of fortune and rank. I don't know how I should take you. I don't know what else I could make you.
You could make me your widow. To be frank, all your anger is
no taste when you married me.
Exactly. I'm late for Lady Sneerwell's.
Such a crew, utterers of forged tales, coiners of scandal, and clippers of reputation.
Would you restrain freedom of speech?
They have made you just as bad as they are.
When I say something rude in their company, it's out of simple good humor, and I assume they say abysmal things about me as well. But you know you promised to come to Lady Sneerwell's too.
I'll be there soon enough just to guard my own reputation.
Then you'd better hurry and get there before I do.
She completely disarms me. How that woman charms me when we're engaged in some strife. Perhaps I overreacted. I've never been so attracted to a woman in all of my life. But I know in my heart, till death do us part, means you may need a gun or a knife. When an old bachelor marries a young wife.
devised the whole thing right from the spot.
I did it just for luck as I was riding in the park.
A tour de force from the back of the horse.
You must tell us what you've got.
It's just a trifle.
But you mustn't stifle your natural gift for rhyme.
You must recite it and don't rewrite it.
We haven't got near enough time.
A lady on a trip to Vancouver thought love would surely improve her. She'd entertain troops in rather large hoops. They'd claim it was just a maneuver.
Lady Teazle, did Sir Peter come with you? He'll be here when he gets through with business. Maria, my love, you look grave. Mr. Surface would like to play cards with you. I take very little pleasure in cards. However, I'll do what your ladyship pleases.
Very good.
Why would he bother with her? I thought he would have embraced this opportunity of speaking to me before Sir Peter came. The house is too much.
Tell me, Mrs. Candour.
They will not admit Miss Vermilion's looks are not cultivated. Truly witty.
solemn
and for good.
But surely you would not be quite so severe on those who just report of that which they hear.
Yes, I would.
Go, you monster, go,
I hold Lady Teazle in the highest regard.
Lady Teazle.
Yet were Sir Peter to suspect us.
Peter suspect us! What's this I see? Does he take her for me? My child, I would very strongly suggest you go in the next room and join the rest.
I assumed this position, for Maria had a suspicion there was something going on between us, and she threatened to go to your husband to say that she had seen us. The child would find it more emphatic if I did something dramatic. But, Lady Teazle, when are you going to give me your judgment on my library, as you promised?
Books! You'd seduce me with books! Though that is tempting.
I die if he suspects.
of your moderation, though an innocent flirtation would be your best revenge.
Oh, you wretch! Not even in jest! Now we really ought to join the rest!
Though I think it would be smart for us to arrive apart. A curious dilemma. My mask has put me in this mess. The task to get me out of it. I don't love Mariah, but I must have her wealth. It cannot go to my brother. I go undercover, I'll do it myself, and have it one way or other. Sir Peter's wife must convince her that I'm a better match than my brother, who'll surely spend it all. Now she thinks that I love her, and I'm concerned she'll prematurely abandon all. I wish it could be understood, as her lover I've been badly misguessed. I'm just no good at being good. And with all the things that have just